This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about adding fractions with different denominators. So here's the first problem. I've got two fractions that I have to add. I've got 4 over 5 and 2 over 7. Now, they have different denominators. If the denominators were the same, this would be an easy problem. All I would have to do is add the numerators together, and that would be the new numerator, and the denominator would stay the same. But when the denominators are different, I have to do a little more work. What I've got to do is find a common denominator for both of these fractions. Now, the common denominator is a number that I can turn both of the denominators into by multiplication. I could turn a 5 into a 35 if I multiplied it by 7, and I can turn a 7 into a 35 if I multiplied it by 5. So 35 could be my common denominator. And here's how I'm going to get those fractions into a form with that common denominator. I'll take the first fraction, 4 over 5, and remember, I wanted to multiply the denominator by 7 to make it 35. Well, if I multiply the denominator by 7, I've got to multiply the numerator by 7 also. I've got to multiply them both by the same thing. Otherwise, I'm changing what the fraction, what the value of the fraction is. So I'll multiply it by 7 over 7. Now, if you think about it, 7 over 7 is just equal to 1. So really, I'm just multiplying this fraction by 1. So let's do the multiplication. When we multiply two fractions, we multiply the numerators to get the new numerator. So 7 times 4 is 28. And then we multiply the denominators to get the new denominator. And 7 times 5 is 35. Now I'm going to do a similar process for the second fraction, 2 over 7. I'll take that 2 over 7. I want to turn the denominator into 35, so I would have to multiply that by a 5, which means I'm going to multiply the whole fraction by 5 over 5, which is just equal to 1. So now I can do the multiplication. 5 times 2 is 10, and 5 times 7 is 35. Now I've got the same denominator for both my fractions. I've got 28 over 35 and 10 over 35. So I can just add the numerators. 28 plus 10 is 38. And the denominator will be that common denominator that I had, which is 35. So I'm going to get 38 over 35 as what happens when I add 4 over 5 plus 2 over 7. I want to take a quick look and make sure I can't reduce 38 over 35, which I can't. So that means that would be my final answer. Now, if you're given a subtraction problem, you're basically going to do the same steps. So let's take all those plus signs and turn them into minus or subtraction signs. Now I've got 4 over 5 minus 2 over 7. That's going to become 28 over 35 minus 10 over 35. And now all I have to do is subtract the numerators. I have to take 28 and subtract 10, and that will give me 18 over 35. I can't reduce that either, so that will be my answer. Okay? Now, I want to do one more just to make a point about common denominators. So, let's take this problem. 5 over 6 plus 3 over 4. And I know a lot of times you're probably told to find the lowest common denominator. Well, I'm not going to do that. So I've got a 6 and a 4, and I'm going to say that the common denominator I want is 24. Now, I know that's not the smallest denominator I could use, but let's just see what happens. So I have to take that 5 over 6, and I have to turn the 6 into a 24, which means I'm going to multiply it by 4, which basically means I'm multiplying by the fraction 4 over 4. And when I do that, 4 over 4 times 5 over 6, I'll get 20 over 24. And now I have to go through the same process for the second fraction, 3 over 4. So I want to turn the denominator into 24, which means I would multiply the denominator by 6. So I'll multiply by the fraction 6 over 6. And now I'll do that multiplication. 6 times 3 is 18. And 6 times 4 is 24. And now I'll add the 20 and the 18. That's 38. And the denominator, I have a common denominator, that's 24. Now, these are both even numbers, 38 and 24. So I could reduce this fraction. I could divide the 38 by 2, and I could divide the 24 by 2, and that would mean I would end up with 19 over 12. Now, I did that without using the lowest common denominator. Let's do it again with the lowest common denominator and see if we get the same answer. So once again, that was 5 over 6 plus 3 over 4. Now, the lowest common denominator is actually 12. So if I want to take the 6 from 5 over 6 and turn that into 12, I'll have to multiply it by 2. So I'll multiply by the fraction 2 over 2. And that's going to give me 10 over 12. And now I do the same process for the 3 over 4. I'll have to multiply that by 3 over 3. That will give me a 12 as my denominator. And 3 times 3 is 9. 3 times 4 is 12. The denominators are the same, so I can add the numerators. And I get 19 over 12. Now that's the same answer I got when I used a denominator that was not the lowest common denominator. So the reason I did this was just to make the point that if you get the lowest common denominator, like I did when I chose 12, that's fine. You probably won't have to reduce anything when you're done. If you don't get the lowest common denominator, such as when I used 24 as my lowest common denominator, then basically you go through with your process and just make sure that you're seeing if you can reduce your answer, if you can simplify your answer. Once you've simplified it, you'll get the same answer you would have gotten if you'd used the lowest common denominator. Okay? So either way, we'll get to the same result. That's about it. Take care. I'll see you next time.